theory is a cyclic exchange theory. In sometimes, whenever we grow, in the cycle we exchange development of spiritualism with them, and at one situation in the cycle they will get spiritual benefit. So likewise, we are developing in science, there will be one day, as per this cyclic exchange phenomenon, now we are developing in science in par excellence with the other countries, one day we will be taught by the Westerners in spiritualism. So the cyclic exchange theory, it says that one day they will be, there is also just this, it is a type of inference. And the fourth theory is resurgence. Each and every theory or each and every system, global system, consists of two eyes. One for their enhancement or empowerment, second is for their emancipation, total liberation. So when something is lower, we have to make the researchers. Now we are lower in the spiritual status, we are very great only in the form of treatises which are in raw materials. In practical work we are not there. So we have to get into researchers. These are all the various theories. Number three, lot of people, they have predicted that the West will fall. Dr. Oswald Spengler, he has written a book known as Decline of the West. Likewise, Emmanuel Todd, he has written a book After the Empire, Breakdown of the American Order. Even Arnold Toynbee, he has predicted about the clash of civilizations. And Mohammed Khatami, the former Iranian president, he has written a book How to Bring Dialogue Between Civilizations and to Prevent the Clash. So likewise, most of the people, they predict the collapse of the Soviet Union, which happened, and also they predict about the West at all. So certainly for resources, both knowledge resources, material resources, we have to come. For that, before saving other countries, we have to save our land from our own inbuilt problems. So we are having lot of internal diseases, external missiles we can handle. We are having lot of, we know that diseases are within our body and medicine is somewhere available outside, but we have both the diseases and medicines inside. Whatever we are having in the innermost resources, that is the medicine. Whatever we are having in the inner resources, that is the disease, and we have to save ourselves for that. Number four, Edmund Burke, he has given a very great ideology. Even if it is in the case of transformation, the case of renaissance, in the case of development, in the case of even terrorism and disruption, it is not committed by lakhs of people. Renaissance or freedom struggle, how many lakhs of people participated? Only a small group of committed people. Even in patriotic struggle, a group of committed people, 100 to 200 people, they participated and a lot of people supported. If somebody can move in the front, there are a lot of thousands of people to follow. They are not ready to go in the front. If somebody can form 10 rows, from the 11th row, there are innumerable flocks of sheep which are awaiting for some comfort and barricades so that they can enter inside. So what we have to do is, in all systems, we have to form at least a 10 row of people who are mightier and who are sound in their nature of execution. So that is what we want. So Edmund Burke told that we need a stronger commitment. We do not require lakhs of people and millions of rupees. Just a small thing, if it is done, a small social transformation can bring a political transformation. A political transformation properly will bring a very great social transformation. They are interrelated. And what is India's contribution of scientific heritage to society? It is to create a real knowledge delivery system. We have to create an environment. There are two things: to change the environment, to create an environment. Nobody can change the environment now immediately. It will take a lot of years, lot of decades, and there is one more danger if you are going to change the environment. First, it is assured that you will be changed by the environment. So it is a very dangerous issue. So you create an environment wherein by you can be taught clearly how to maintain your physique, how to modulate and control your mind, how to sharpen and direct your talents in the form of intellect, and how to scintillate your spirit. We have to take care of these things, in which the scientists coming from this community, the social animators coming from this community, can bring real inventions. What are real inventions? That we are giving, that the which are capable of giving long-term benefit, multifaceted benefit, all-round benefit, not immediate benefit, interim benefit, and instantaneous benefit. So that which can bring long-run benefit, that which can bring all round happiness and benefit, that we can create multifaceted development in the society, that is known as real benefit. Only such people can give that. This incubation center is the only real scientific heritage of India which West cannot even imagine. All the other things they can imagine and do, this is something ananya sadhana which cannot be done by anybody, etc., for which we want to establish a system through multiversity which has a rural hunt. Anil Kakodkar recently has announced that we are going to get lot of people to be trained in nuclear engineering and nuclear power management from a rural community. Now he has announced it in the paper also. Likewise, we have to go for rural hunt, because rural people, they are lesser polluted. That's what we believe. So rural hunt is the first thing, and second thing is serene campus. We have to start a serene campus instead of a sensational and violent campus which is available now. Serene campus. Third thing is impressionable inculcation, in which the students are brought that within a very impressionable age, before they learn what is good and bad, they must be vaccinated by us. That is known as impressionable inculcation. Number fourth thing, beneficial and blissful way of instruction, information and infrastructure. And number five, radiant leadership. We have to bring radiant leadership among the society who can make this event successful. Only learning center, there are two learning centers. One is the domestic learning center and second is the academic learning center. Unless we create a lineage, we have to make a parampara. We cannot make people, making people cannot bring any benefit at all immediately. We have to make a parampara. If we can start now the process of inculcation and purification of the society after four or five generations, because loss or the depreciation of the society was gradual and it happened over generations, so the benefit should also be brought over generations. Let us start together. That is the value of scientific heritage. And on various issues I have raised, certainly scientific heritage society as well as Vigyan Bharati and Multiversity should take, we must take issues of controversy. If we are taking all comfortable issues, we cannot withstand in the global platform, rationalistic platform and scientific community. We can just get ourselves adorned and applauded by like-minded people and nodders. So we want to go in a higher platform, for which we have to take the controversial things, incongruities, incompatibilities, all of these things, if they are rationally approached and scientifically, disciplinically, if it is deliberated between the scientific community as well as the traditional spiritual community, that is the real bridging of the science with modern science, traditional science with modern science. And we have to take these issues for a detailed discussion, and I hope that that will be the continuity of today's what we call the scintillation, the today's spark that we have instilled inside you by this Congress. That should be a blazing fire that should not be extinguished by your domestic diversions and by your financial affairs. It should be more made pleasant, radiant and brilliant by means of further communications, because I hope that such a detailed seminar will be conducted soon. Narayan, Narayan.